Hi, Erwan from MotionVFX. I'm very excited to introduce you to our new pack for DaVinci Resolve mTutorial. mTutorial will help you to create better educational videos with appealing effects. To get access to the massive content of the pack, click on the Effects tab. The best way to get access to all the content at once, click on Toolbox, then in the search field, type mTutorial. It will display over 100 elements like focus, placeholder, add-ons, backgrounds, guides, lower thirds, pointers, titles, transitions, and many more. I will do some inception as I will work on the DaVinci Resolve tutorial. To start, let's add a title. There are 17 titles available. You can preview title by skimming the thumbnail with a cursor. I will drag and drop the title 8 over my first clip. First, I will offset the position of the background video to the right. To do so, I will open the inspector and adjust the X position. I can check at the beginning if it is okay. Then I will select the title to modify it. First, you can enable or disable the in and out animations. In this case, I will keep the animation in, but I will disable the animation out. I will quickly adjust the size and the position of the background. Okay, let's customize the title. In the content controls, you can adjust the position, the size, and the rotations of the global title. To reset any parameter, just double-click on the name of the parameter. With the title and subtitle controls, you can edit the text. I will modify the subtitle and add the name of the lesson. I will also modify the footer text and type DaVinci Resolve 101. Of course, you can modify any elements of each title, color, size, and typography. Inside the element controls, you can enable or disable the line and modify various parameters like the color of the background. And lastly, you can adjust the drop shadow. To be able to read in real time the title, I will go to the playback menu and set the render cache option to smart. When the red line will become blue, the render will be done, so I can play it in real time. Next, I would like to show the switch to the color page and where the user have to click. So I will set the player just before the click on the color button. mTutorial provides many pointers elements that will help you for this kind of need. And drag the pointer 7 over my clip. I will select it. With the content controls, I will adjust the position. And with the text controls, I will edit the text. I will adjust the size between the space, the circle, and the text. I will offset a little bit the circle as I don't want the text too low. And we are good. Let's play it. I may need to change the timing. It seems a little bit too late. Okay, perfect. Next, I would like to get the attention of the viewer on the main toolbox. With the focus elements, you have many possibilities to highlight parts of the interface. Of course, each element are fully customizable. Focus elements are effects, so you have to drag them directly to the video clip. The only issue is the fact that until today, DaVinci Resolve doesn't manage very well the animation from the effects with stream video clips. So most of the time, animation won't appear, like here. But don't worry, there is a workaround. First, I will remove the effect by clicking on the trash can icon. Then, I will drag and drop an adjustment clip that you can find with the default DaVinci Resolve effects. I will adjust the duration to match with the duration of the clip. Then, I will drag my focus preset number 3 on the adjustment clip. Now we can see the animation. The advantage to use adjustment clip is the fact that you can retime effects very easily. You won't have to modify your edit or add cuts. As it is an effect, to modify the parameters, you will have to click on the Effects tab inside the inspector. I will quickly modify the position and the size of the element. You can also modify the position directly inside the viewer. To do so, just enable the Fusion Overlay option. On this preset, you can adjust the roundness parameter of the rectangle. The amount of blur can be customized. In this case, I don't need blur, so I will disable the background blur parameter. Next, the action is mostly on the top left of the interface with the selection of the LUT. so I would like to zoom on this part to get a better view on the content. I will add an adjustment clip. And I will use the focus preset number 14. This one will add a zoom effect. By default, it will zoom in the center of the video. You can modify the X and Y position of the pivot point to get the top left part of the interface. Then, with the zoom amount, I will be able to increase the size of the interface. To be able to play the animation in real time, do a right click and go to Render Cache Fusion Effect Filter and select your effect. One important part of this effect is the in and out animations. You can be very accurate as you can select which type of interpolation you want with the animation curve parameter. By default, the custom interpolation creates an acceleration. You can click on the drop-down menu to get access to two other interpolation types, linear and easing. I will test both. I like the easing interpolation with a smoother animation. As we are zooming inside the video, there is a sharpen parameter that can help you to get back some details. I think the effect starts too late. I will use the benefit to have an adjustment clip and I will trim the endpoint over the previous clip. Next, I would like to show the click on the last tab. So I will combine the effect with a pointer element, the pointer number 3. I will use the Fusion overlay to quickly move the circle animation over the cursor. By default, the title duration is set to 5 seconds. We can see that the timing is not good, too late, and the animation is too slow. So I will reduce the duration of the pointer. It will automatically increase the speed. I will zoom inside the timeline to be more accurate. Okay, the timing is good now, matching with the background video. Next, I would like to see the complete interface when previewing the various slots. So I will trim the out point of the adjustment clip. The effect will automatically adjust the outgoing animation. On the next shot, I would like to indicate a right click that will give us access to a drop-down menu. There are some add-on elements mimicking the mouse. I will drag the add-on number 2 over my clip with a white mouse. The mouse is fully customizable. First, I will increase a little bit the size. Then, inside the animation controls, you can decide which animations you want to keep. In this case, I want the right click, so I will disable the left click. With video tutorials, it's great to give extra information like the keyboard shortcuts. In this case, the video shows how to add a serial node with a right click, but I can also display the keyboard shortcut. I will use the add-on number 5. This preset is very complete. First, I will adjust the position. Inside the button controls, you can choose to display until 4 hotkeys. You can adjust any details like the size and color of the background hotkeys. Here I will replace Control by S as Option plus S will add a serial node. With the sign controls I will adjust the plus sign in the middle. Let's play it. mTutorial provides many lower third elements. It will be very useful to introduce a tutor, for example, or add informations. As you can modify many parameters, they are very versatile. I will use one lower third as a callout element. I will drag and drop lower third number 3. This one is composed by a text element, but also with a line with a circle. First, I will quickly modify the text and the size of the background element. Then I will adjust the position of the line. I will remove the drop shadow to get a better contrast. It seems too short, so I will increase the duration. Let's play it. For the end of this lesson, I would like to create some interaction with the viewer. So I will suggest 3 lessons to proceed with the training. Inside the timeline, I've imported 3 screenshots. one for the edit lesson, one for the color grading lesson, and the third for the fusion lesson. To create a quick graphic with the three options, I will use the placeholder element. Placeholder provides great animation with style, and they are so easy to use. I will use the placeholder number 4, and I will drag the effect on the edit screenshot. As usual, everything is customizable. In the content controls, there is an extra option, media position. By default, this preset is set to 4 elements. But of course, you can use it for less, like here with my 3 elements. So I will edit the various text. Inside the media controls, you can modify many parameters of the screenshot. By pressing Command plus C, I will copy the clip, and I will enable the second screenshot. And on the second screenshot, I will paste the attributes by pressing Option plus V to paste the effect. I will select Fusion Effect in the Paste Attribute window and click on Apply. I will switch to position 2 and offset the position to set the element in the middle. I will disable the first title as I don't need it, and I will customize the various text. I will reproduce the same technique for the third fusion screenshot. Okay, to be sure that everything is at the right place, I will use the guides provided with mTutorial. There are various types of guides for various needs. I will get the grid and drag it over my composition. Of course, you can adapt the grid to your need by adjusting the number of lines and all the parameters. In this case, I will need to adjust a little bit the position of the middle element to be perfectly in the center. When you don't need any more guide, you can disable it by pressing D or just delete it. To complete this composition, I would like to get some animated background. mTutorial provides 8 animated backgrounds with various styles. I will add the background number 4 and place it below the 3 elements. And like all the elements, backgrounds are fully customizable. I will adjust the light color and we are done. Let's see some different usage of mTutorial. mTutorial is very versatile and you can cover almost every educational content. For example, here I've got a video tutorial on a vegan cooking lesson. So no more interface, but live video content and still pictures. For the title, I will use as a background the stop motion animation. I will add the title number 10. I will modify the text. This title has some drop zone that you can fill with pictures. You can use logos, but in this case, I will display vegetables that we will need for this lesson. By default, there are 4 pictures that you can add, but you can disable some if you need less. Next, I will create the page to present the chef and the tutor, Hiro Takashi. I will drag a placeholder effect on the picture of the chef, preset number 11. It will create automatically a nice animation. I will modify the title with the name of the chef and his location. Then I will copy-paste the resume. Inside the media controls, I will adjust the size of the pictures. And to add subtle animation in the background, I will place below the background number 1. Placeholder can be also very useful to create a nice picture-in-picture effect with text that you can easily customize. On this one, I will disable the in and out animation as I will use a transition from mTutorial, the preset number 5. I will add it at the beginning and at the end of the clip, and we are done. With over 100 elements, mTutorial for DaVinci Resolve will cover almost all you need for the creation of your educational content. This video reveals just a glimpse of all the possibilities offered with this pack. To get more information, go to motionvfx.com where you can find all the details on each preset. Thanks for watching. Ciao ciao. Bye bye.